Next one is Michael addition. We also call it as 1, 4 addition. 1, 4 addition. Possible when one of the carbonyl compound is conjugate. Conjugate carbonyl compound. Conjugate carbonyl compound. Okay. You see this reaction. Suppose we have R C double bond O CH2 C double bond O plus CH3 CH double bond CH C double bond O R or H anything like this. Okay. C double bond O R. Okay. Now this R and this reaction takes place in presence of a base, right? And solvent, if you have to take, the solvent will be conjugate acid of this base, pH. Okay, right? This R can be it can be hydrogen also. Instead of this R you can take, or you can also take OR. Ester also you can take for this reaction. Okay. Means if it is there aldehyde, HC double bond O or OR C double bond O like this, then we'll have the same similar kind of reaction. Nothing changed with there. Right. Now you see this aldehyde is conjugated, yes or no? Pi, sigma, pi. Right. This is conjugated aldehyde. So mechanism, everything exactly same, but in case of conjugation, what happens? This carbon won't take part in the reaction. That is what you need to understand, right? So what happens here, you see, first of all, this carbon, this CH2, is active methylene group, yes or no? Active methylene group, you know what is active methylene group? Methylene group is CH2, okay? Methylene group is CH2. So when this CH2 has two electron withdrawing group present, if you remember, in tautomerism we have done it. Right, two methylene active. Suppose this side also we have CH3 and this side also we have CH3. So if you see the acidity of this hydrogen and this hydrogen, which one is most acidic hydrogen? The center one, because both group is withdrawing electron. So for this carbon, it is very easy to lose H plus. Correct. So this kind of group where CH2 present between the two electron withdrawing group, we call it as active methylene group. CH2 is already methylene, right? It is active methylene group. So if H plus has to come out in this molecule, it will come from the middle carbon, right? The active methylene group carbon, because that hydrogen is most acidic hydrogen. Correct? So what happens here? Again, you see the mechanism is same. The only thing is what we need to generate the carbon ion, which behaves as a nucleophile and that attacks onto the other molecule. वही तो कर रहे हैं ना last reaction में क्या किया था CN minus से attack hua and then hydride shift hua and then we'll get carbon ion. And that carbon ion attacks on the molecule, right? So yahan bhi we have to do the same thing. So what happens here, this base takes H plus, right? Aur ye H plus kahan se lega? Jo H plus most acidic hai, right? So this H plus is most acidic, right? So it takes H plus from this carbon and we'll get a carbon ion here, right? And then this carbon ion attacks on which carbon? Other reaction, if you see, when there is no conjugation, the carbon ion were attacking onto the carbonyl carbon. But since there is a conjugation, so this will attack onto this carbon, this pi shift over here, and this electron shift over here. This pi is in resonance, right? So this comes over here, this goes here, this goes here, right? So this attack of this carbon ion takes place on the fourth carbon. Why fourth carbon? Because we are counting from this one. This is nothing related to nomenclature, 1, 4. The number is not related to nomenclature. It's just first position is this, second is this, third is this, and fourth is this. And that's why we are calling it as 1,4 addition. So Michael addition is just a name. It is basically 1,4 addition, right? So when it attacks over here, right? This carbon also, when you draw this electron here and here, this positive charge resonance is stabilized, right? That's why we'll get more stable carbocation, and hence attacks over here, right? So basically, you have to keep this in mind. The reason is that stability only, but when we have aldehyde or ketone is in conjugation, right? And then the attack of this carbonyl carbon, or sorry, the carbon ion takes place onto the fourth carbon, right? Onto the fourth carbon, because this is in resonance with this, okay? So can you write down the mechanism? First step, what you do, base takes H plus from this, you'll get lone pair negative charge here, and then second step, it attacks onto this carbon, this pi electron shift over here. Write down this two step first. I'll write down this first, we try this once. Okay, so in the first step, what happens? RC double bond O, CH2, C double bond O, R, and base takes this hydrogen. The product will be R, C double bond O, CH negative, R. The second step of the reaction, the carbon ion attacks on this aldehyde, conjugated aldehyde, CH3CH double bond CH, C double bond OH. This attacks onto this carbon, fourth carbon, this comes over here, and this pi electron shift onto this oxygen. So it forms R C double bond O CH C double bond O R, and then we'll get CH, one methyl group is here, CH double bond CO minus H. Okay, the next step from the solvent, that is BH, this oxygen gets protonates from the solvent, and B minus will be there in the solvent, right? So it will be R C double bond O CH C double bond O R CH CH3 CH double bond C H O H. This is enol form, yes or no? Enol. Okay? Enol, enol form. So whenever we have enol form, we'll try to write keto form. So must take care of this. If you're getting this, and in the option keto form is given, so try to write down keto form from enol form, because keto is in, it is in general more stable, right? If there is no other factor like aromaticity and all, right? So this, after this, the last step is the keto enol tautomerism. Okay, how do we write keto enol tautomerism? The H plus comes out from the first carbon, first atom, and attach onto the third. So it's 1,3 addition, right? Triad, we call it as. You have done this one, diad, triad, and space tautomer, right? So it is triad. This H comes out, leaves this bond pair of electron to this carbon. So if I write down this, H is here. This comes over here, right? This pi electron comes over here, and it takes this H plus onto this carbon. So the product of this reaction will be RC double bond O CH C double bond O R CH CH3 CH2 C double bond O. So how do we write down the product? Because again, mechanism you are not going to write in the exam. Okay, so करना क्या है यहाँ से we'll take this H plus out, ठीक है, and we add this here onto this carbon, third carbon, right? Everything will be as it is, double bond को हटा देंगे, ठीक है, and this carbon attached with this carbon, right? So 1,4 addition. If you get this compound 1,4 addition करना, so directly if I write down, this two will be as it is. Directly write down the product, R C double bond O. This is the active methylene group CH, and this attached with this thing will be same, C double bond O R. and this attached with the fourth atom here. So fourth atom is this, which is carbon CH, and this carbon we have this CH3, so this CH3 will be here, single bond CH, single bond C double bond OH. Now this carbon, the valency is not complete, so write down simply here. That is what the product we have. Okay, not that important. Only thing you need to keep in mind, if it is conjugation, then 1,4 addition over. Write down the product in this reaction. Try to write it down directly, don't write mechanism. Okay. Reagent, you see, reagent we have, if you have OET present, then the reagent will be the salt of this ET O minus Na plus, and the solvent of this is what? ET OH. Okay. Other reagent we are using here is H plus H2O, and in the last step we are heating this one. So one thing you take care here, if it is OET, then you take the salt of this group only, right? OR, if it is there, then you take the salt with respect to that group. What is the product we get? The fourth carbon is this 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? And carbon ion will get here under this carbon, negative charge. So this carbon and this carbon will attach. Right? So the product is directly, if I write down the product, we'll have double bond O, then
CH2
C double bond O OET and C double bond O OET. Is it correct? Yes. Even again, right? Now, in the, because this is the reaction that we did just now, 1,4 addition is this. And in that reaction, we are not using H plus H2. So when you use H plus H2O, this reaction is not different from it. This is the product of the first reagent that we are using. If you use H plus H2O further, then this will, this H plus protonates this OET and OET, and finally ETOH comes out and we get acid over here, COOH, COOH. See, SO1 is on it. So, remember this, okay? I'll explain the mechanism here. So, ध्यान रखना. COOR. Suppose you have this C double bond O, OR. ठीक है? एक bond है. H plus H2O के साथ this reaction. First of all, this OR gets protonates. And it forms C double bond O ओ आर एच पॉजिटिव चार्ज, ठीक है। नाउ दिस टेक्स दिस बॉन्ड पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड इट फॉर्म्स सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ पॉजिटिव चार्ज एंड आर ओ एच। आई एम जस्ट राइटिंग इट डाउन टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस, ओके। एग्जैक्ट मैकेनिज्म इज नॉट लिखा, ओके। एंड देन ऑन दिस पॉजिटिव चार्ज द एच टू ओ बिहेव एज अ न्यूक्लियोफाइल एंड इट अटैक्स ऑन दिस चार्ज एंड कन्वर्ट्स इनटू सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ ओ एच टू प्लस एंड द फाइनल स्टेप व्हाट हैपेंस टू स्टेबलाइज दिस पॉजिटिव चार्ज H plus comes out and it converts into C double bond O. The final product of this is what? Acetic hydrolysis of ester. It is an acid plus alcohol. Okay? Acetic hydrolysis of ester gives you acid and alcohol. So when you do the acetic hydrolysis of this, we get what? All these things will be same. And we get double bond O, CH2, CH, C double bond O OH, C double bond O OH plus what we get? Two molecules of ET OH acid and alcohol. Now when you heat this, because we're heating this also, so when you heat this and the carbon contains it is dicarboxylic acid, right? So dicarboxylic acid, if you heat when it contains only one carbon in between, then CO2 molecules comes out. So yaad rakhna hai, it's heating effect of compounds. Okay? If there is two carbon in between, you must have remembered this reaction. This is very important, okay? Because kahin kahin pe hota kya hai, H2O eliminate hota hai. Dikhao ga tumne. Heat kiya, H2O eliminate ho gaya. Kahin pe CO2 eliminate ho gaya. Right? So what you have to keep in mind, when the carbon, number of carbon atom is one in between the two carboxylate group, right? Suppose aisa hai, अगर रिएक्शन ये तो देख लिया तुमने, सपोज मैं ये लिख रहा हूँ, देखा होगा एनहाइड्राइड फॉर्मेशन, सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ ओ एच, सी डबल बॉन्ड ओ ओ एच, ठीक है, सपोज ऐसा कुछ है, या बेंजीन रिंग नहीं भी है तो रिएक्शन भी होगा, ठीक है। नाउ व्हेन यू हीट दिस, इन दिस केस व्हाट हैपेंस, H2O मॉलिक्यूल्स गोज आउट, CO2 नहीं जाएगा, H2O हो जाएगा, तो यहां से OH H2O चला जाएगा एंड यू आर गेटिंग व्हाट, फैलिक एनहाइड्राइड। This one is phthalic acid and we get phthalic hydride from this. Okay? So what you have to keep in mind, in case of dicarboxylic acid, if two carbon atom is present in between, the two carboxylic group, right, two carboxylic acid group, then H2O molecules goes out in the reaction if you heat this. Okay? Or if there one carbon hai, then CO2 molecules goes out. Okay? It's very important. Only one carbon present, heat this, CO2 molecules goes out. So what the final product of this reaction is what?
CH3.
When you heat this, any one of the CO2 molecules goes out and the product will be C double bond O here, CH2, CH2, C double bond O, OH.
Why can't both the CO2 go?
See, then for that you need to understand the mechanism. Actually, hota kuch aisa hai mechanism, I'll tell you. See, when you heat this, because they are not using any reagent, so one of the hydrogen atom, either this hydrogen or this hydrogen, right, one of the hydrogen atom comes out, leaving this electron pair behind. ठीक है, यहाँ पे C double bond O double bond O हो गया, और this carbon will have what? Negative charge on it. ठीक है, carbon has 5 bonds, so negative charge, right? After this, this bond pair is like it is there on this carbon and CO2 comes out from this reaction. और H plus निकला था यहाँ से, carbon के पास negative charge हुआ, तो ये जो carbon है ये H plus निकलता है और CH2 हो जाता है. So this is not taking place with both the molecule. That's why the carboxylate group on the same carbon is unstable. Slightly you hit this, CO2 molecules goes out. But when we have monocarboxylic acid, it is stable. It won't eliminate CO2. क्योंकि यहाँ पे देखो स्टेबिलिटी का कोई रीजन नहीं है, अगर ये निकलेगा अभी तो सी एच थ्री यहाँ पे आएगा, ठीक है, और उसके लिए यू नीड वेरी हाई हीट, दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल, राइट, सो होता नहीं. सो पॉइंट इज व्हेन यू हैव टू कार्बन एटम प्रेजेंट बिटवीन द टू कार्बोक्सिलेट एसिड ग्रुप, ऑन हीटिंग दिस H2O मॉलिक्यूल्स गोज आउट एंड यू एंड अप गेटिंग एन एनहाइड्राइड, राइट, ओनली वन कार्बन एटम, देन CO2 गोज आउट एंड यू विल गेट एसिड. Okay, so final product of this reaction is what? is this. So first step of this reaction is Michael addition, and then simply the acidic hydrolysis and heating. Right? So these two things, one carbon and two carbon, is very important for this carbonyl compound chapter, especially carboxylic acid. Okay? Understood?